My name is Chris Pizer. I'm the broadcast communications, film and media teacher at the Hazleton Area Career Center.
Hi, I'm Crystal Lyons. I'm an English teacher at the Hazleton Area Career Center, where I've been teaching for the past 5 years. Mr. Pizer and I have been working collaboratively for the past few months on a project which is titled Engaging Short Films.
And with this project, what we wanted to do was have the students create a short film based on an adaption that they've created from a piece of literature.
The idea behind the project is to take different pieces of classic literature that the students have been exposed to in their English courses and then adapt those pieces of literature into a screenplay, which they would then use to shoot a short film. We selected pieces from 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th and 12th grade courses, and they are pieces that the students really enjoyed reading. So we wanted to make sure that they enjoyed it, because if they enjoyed it, then they would put more work into it.
The other thing I really wanted to accomplish with this lesson was incorporate more of the core academics into this lesson. And our building is kind of unique, and it's set up in a way that really allows us to do that better than maybe some of the other career and technical schools.
The building at the Career Center is very unique because we are self-sustained, which means that not only are there shop vocational programs here, we also have the academic courses, so it allows for us to work collaboratively anytime we really want to. And when Mr. Pizer approached me several months ago about this project for students to produce these short films, that's when we started to get the ball rolling on what they would actually do.
I'm a big movie buff, and I love this project because it allows me to show students how a film is really put together, how a scene is shot, different camera angles are used together. When students come to me and I give them their first project where they have to shoot multiple angles, they tend to shoot things in sequence. So if there is a line by one actor and then another actor and then back to the first actor, they tend to shoot that sequentially how it would end up in the final edit. They'll shoot the first scene of the actor talking, and then they'll shoot the second line from the second actor saying their line, and kind of they'll bounce back and forth and shoot it the same way it gets edited. And that's not really the way it's done. With this project, I focus on what's called the triangle shooting method, where you have your actors run through a scene. And just like they do in Hollywood, they have actors will run through a scene multiple times and they'll get used to doing it exactly the same so that the edits match up. You'll shoot what's called your master shot, which is kind of like a wide shot showing everything in the scene. And the actors will run through and they'll say their lines. Each actor will say their lines. And then they'll strike the set and they'll move to usually what they call a single, which is usually an over-the-shoulder shot showing the one actor, and they'll perform that whole scene again where both actors will say their lines, but the focus is on the actor who's speaking at the time, and you'll see their face. Then you'll switch everything around, shoot the same scene one more time, and get it from the other angle and show the close-up of the second actor saying their lines. And then when it all gets put together, you edit those three shots together with a couple other things, something called inserts and cutaways, and maybe an establishing shot, and then you get your scene. That style of shooting, that triangle shooting method, is really the technical focus of this project. This project also allows me to incorporate all the foundational stuff they've learned up to this point and kind of put it into one final project, utilizing all those skills that they've accumulated through the course of the 1 or 2 or 3 years that they've been in the program. This lesson is kind of a culmination of all those things, and then this last lesson kind of puts all that together and shows them a practical way to do it.
It first started off with just producing a short film, and it eventually turned into this big unique project where the students not only would just produce the film, but they are actually going to showcase this at two different events. They will practice, do a practice run through their classroom, and then secondly they would present this at a competition, and then finally in May they're going to present it to the public at a gallery night. And it's not a matter of just Mr. Pizer grading it. There are also professionals within the business coming in and will assess the students' presentation and the film itself.
The template that was provided by Marty and the TAP program really allowed me to really break down the project into every individual component. And at first, honestly, I thought it seemed a little redundant. I thought, why are we stating the same stuff over and over again? But after working through it and kind of finally finishing up the template, I realized that this really gives you a perfect roadmap of your project that just takes you through it every step of the way and allows you enough room that you can make changes and you could insert in some of what Marty calls just-in-time learning. If you need to refresh your students on something you've learned or there's something you kind of didn't think about and you get to it, there's enough flexibility in this template that you could insert those lessons and make this project work. I don't think this project is done. I think it's something that's going to continue to evolve year after year. It will only get better and better as we learn from the experiences and the mistakes of the previous year. But I think this template and the TAP program has really given me the tools I need to really just fine-tune this project and make it just the ultimate project that I'll use in my classroom every year.